Cell phones make it possible for inmates to run criminal enterprises in and outside of jail.
It's a decision made.
But for the past 4 years, the House Judiciary Committee has killed legislation sought by corrections officials, making smuggling and possession of a cell phone a felony.
We already have a law. The only thing new that this bill would have done would have made it a felony. And a felony status for smuggling a cell phone, to me, was not realistic. Felonies are serious crimes. They're murders, they're rapes, robberies.
4 of the 6 city delegates who sit on the committee voted against the measure this year. The city delegation chair is the one who requested a public inquiry into corruption allegations at the jail following the unsealing of a federal indictment, alleging the Black Gorilla Family Gang took control of the facility. Guards smuggled in cell phones and drugs. 4 female corrections officers had sex with the gang leader who fathered children with them.
Some of the public may say, well, gee, you know, given the circumstances of the indictment on the city jail, wouldn't anything be helpful?
No, because, you know, that's, again, it's to minimize their responsibility and maximize the responsibility of the legislature. Their responsibility is to have corrections officers and have proper security at the facilities. That's their responsibility, not to have enhanced penalties for people that are already mainly incarcerated.
It's been a misdemeanor since 2007, carrying a 3-year penalty. The judge has sentencing discretion. The proposed legislation makes it a felony for second offenders and tacks 5 years onto their jail time. And judges have no leeway in sentencing.
We would consider enhancing penalties for corrections officers only, and they couldn't argue honestly that they had truly been prosecuting under the misdemeanor.
The federal indictment alleges guards often were waved through security. The so-called boss chair, which detects metal, was only used in special circumstances. A $350,000 grant provided in 2011 funded 2 investigators and a special prosecutor for cell phone cases. Since January, corrections forwarded 140 cell phone cases to the city state's attorney's office, resulting in 64 charges.
The hype about this particular situation is not enough to cause me to say, oh no, this is a felony. It's not a felony. It's a misdemeanor punishable by 3 years in jail, and we should punish them that way.